Please make a U-turn while safe.
Why can't people drive in this car?
Once more, turn left.
Bernie, what's wrong?
Nothing, sweetie. Oh my God, you're the lucky one.
What?
You could slice cheese on those puppies. I must be the only slob without cheekbones. I'm thinking of getting implants.
But you sounded hysterical.
Oh, sometimes I can't bear to be alone. I'm so glad you've come back into my life, even if you did try to kill me. I'm so excited.
What are we doing here?
We're going to have fun!
Fun?
Yes! It's a four-letter word, I know, but we can still try.
Look, more people want me dead than alive. I'm working for the Mafia. The police and the government agency are both on my case. I kill and steal to scrape together a living so that my cousin can fritter it away online and pay off debts. And all the while, people are trying to kill us! What is fun?
Honey, you are stressed.
Oh. Goodbye, Florian.
No, you don't, Nico. I need you. I need you to come on this boat trip with me. I need to talk to someone who truly knows me.
When I knew you, you were training to be a shepherd. And you wanted to be a professional wrestler. Actually, maybe it does all make sense.
You understand me. Both of me! Come on, Bryce accidentally left the keys on purpose somewhere I could steal them. You drive, I'll work on my tan. My midriff is really pale.
All right. Let's have fun.
Head out to sea, sailor! My life is in turmoil. Bryce is pulling his hair out over this blackmail thing. His wife is getting on his back about yours truly. I think she suspects. It's a nightmare.
I don't know how else I can help you. Look how long it took me to find you.
I know, sweetie. Let's forget about him and have some F-U-N. Perfect, sweetie. Let's stop. Ahoy, sailor! Cute guys off the starboard brow! Scratch that. Not so cute. Rouge-ni Rusi!
Let me see. They don't look like they're on the pleasure cruise.
Bryce's wife is going to freak out about his boat. This was meant to be our fun day, Nico. Why does everything that's meant to be fun have to be so miserable?
I don't know. We just got to get these guys or they'll just come back. I told you that there was no time for this. People are after me, and I have to stay alert. You, Bert, are in this too. You have to keep your eyes open.
They're wide open, sweetie. I'm focused. 100%. Let's get them. Oh! our noble hero returns from battle.
They're not a problem anymore.
Nico, you are my knight in shining armor. Thank you. I'm sorry our fun day wasn't so very much fun. See you soon.
See you.
Shit, he more and more resists
him. Get
fight. Out of the car or I will kill you.
Did you see that shit? I don't believe this shit.
Say that the father's insane.
Please proceed to highlighted route.
I'm here to see Mr. Gravelli. I was sent by a mutual friend.
Come on. Someone here to see you.
Yeah. So you're the one who's getting involved with that nonsense for my dear friend, James Pecorino.
I don't know what
you're... Spare me, please. I'm an old man. I ain't got much time left. Our mutual friend told me everything. Thank you. It made me
My pleasure.
People are so damn vain.
Some people?
All people. Even you, even me, an old man facing the end. And I still care. Care how I look. Care that when I shit myself, the pretty nurse has to clean it up. It's ridiculous.
Yeah, well, you know.
And I care about my legacy. I've worked hard for this line of work. Now some Russian assholes think they can march in and take control of rackets my family has run for 50 years.
You mean 50 years of you bleeding the city dry might finally come to an end?
I know it's a terrible tragedy. But if it wasn't me, it would just be someone else. So it might as well be me.
Yes.
Let me tell you, that faggot friend of yours, Bernie Crane, his boyfriend, he's being blackmailed by them damn Russians. They want him to put certain contracts up for tender. Windows, bus lines, cleaning, ones we control. These Russian fucking bastards are trying to finish us.
What do you want me to do about it?
I want you to work with me.
In exchange for what?
The police have a file on you an inch thick. In exchange for that. In exchange for that guy you've been asking about being brought here from wherever it is he's hiding, Switzerland or some shit.
Okay, good. What do you want me to do?
A good friend of mine is coming into town to give a speech on the new threat to Liberty City, Russian organized crime. I got a feeling some people ain't gonna want that speech to happen. Maybe the guy you love, this Dmitry Raskolov, has an interest in keeping this story out of the press. Make sure our boy gets to City Hall. He's coming in from upstate. He'll be at Grand Eastern Terminal on Bismarck. Thank you.
Yourself a little more.
You guys waiting for me?
Nico Bellic, right?
Yeah, that's me.
Stay in convoy with us all the way to City Hall, all right?
Sure.
John, how are you? Of course. Well, I'm coming to see you as soon as I've delivered the speech. Don't say that, John. You'll be feeling like a teenager again in no time. Those are the wonders of modern medicine. Where do you think you're going? Well, I'm gonna bring up everything we discussed. When I'm done at the podium, Mayor Ochoa is gonna be dedicating half his annual budget to cleaning this problem up. He doesn't want to start getting reckless with the lives of Liberty City voters. Driver, why is this road closed? Is there a problem?
Another roadblock? This definitely wasn't mentioned on the traffic report. I'm gonna go and move the barriers.
Come on, Mr. Jefferson! Let's get out of here!
get out of there.
That was a mistake they didn't want to make. If you're gonna try to take out a politician, you better take him out for sure.
Thanks for the advice.
American gangsters like John Gravelli understand the way life works. They get the limits of their power. In Europe, the politicians are as crooked as the gangsters. We don't understand that things are different here.
Yeah, sure. You are as clean as the driven snow. I'll explain that important cultural difference to one of the more Russians wanting to kill you. How about that?
Extreme sport street comes in Arctic douche, icicle fire, and yellow snow. Push your body to the extreme. Then bring it back to hell. Electrolytes extreme sports.
This is reckless speed you're using.
Please make a U-turn, we're safe.
I don't know who you are, but you got me here. Goes to show, some immigrants have the best interest of the country in their hearts. I'll tell John you did well.
It's real quiet out here.
Adjusting interest rates at some point. Is it a bear or is it a ball bust? We're not sure, and I doubt you are either.
And get ready for some extreme glory in orbit. Excelsior Extreme 9 looks to become the first...
Mr. Gravelli, I took that friend of yours to City Hall. He should be giving a speech any minute.
You did good. Heard you had some trouble along the way. You can always rely on those Russians to try something. How are we supposed to compete with these immigrant criminals when they want it so bad?
You're working with me, aren't you, Mr. Gravelli? See you later.
Thank you.
My favorite internet cafe worker is still here. Good to see you. What's up, Bernie?
I wanted to give you something to say thank you for me and Bryce. Well, he doesn't know I'm giving you this, but he gave it to me, so it's technically from him.
What is it?
This car. Enjoy! I only power walk or take cabs, so I figured I should pass this on to my savior.
Thanks, man. I appreciate that.
Don't mention it. What we've got is worth more than money.
Oh my god. What the... what the fuck was that?
Time to empty the bedpans.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Nico, good to see you.
You too. How are you, Mr. Gravelli?
Good, good. I was just speaking to our mutual friend about you. He said how efficient you were. I like that. Then he mentioned something about a Darko Brevich.
What? He did?
Yeah. He's located the guy. It seems he wasn't in Switzerland at all, but in Bucharest. He'll be here soon.
Good. Good.
And it seems your Russian friends are getting the message. Some of them.
Oh, okay, so...
I think it's our turn to do a favor for that mutual friend of ours. Seems some Korean has come into the country and... and is selling money at a discount. You don't need me to tell you that it's all fugazi. Faker than a pair of vinewood tits.
That's good.
Listen. I need you to deal with this. Eliminate the guy. What he's doing is no good for the economy and no good for patriots like you and me.
Huh. So who is he?
His name is Kim Young-guk. He'll be very well protected. He eats at Mr. Fook. Fuck.
Mr. Gravelli, are you all right?
Yeah. I'm fine. Wait. what was I saying?
Kim Jong-guk, he eats at...
Yeah, right. Right. He eats at a restaurant called Mr. Fook's Rice Box. Yeah, in Alderney City.
Don't worry. I'll take care of it. Some other time, okay?
Route. You have arrived.
Shit!
Where is Kim?
He's upstairs, speaking with the manager. They don't want to see nobody, though.
Kim and I are old friends.
Kim got a lot of money. He don't need no friends. Get lost!
Run! Don't kill me! I'm not...
You're dead, friend!
You are a dead man! You must come out now! There's nowhere to run!
You're making a big mistake!
There's no way out!
Wait, if you play stupid, you're not going to live very long. Where's Kim?
He heard you come. He ran out back through the kitchen.
This last false bill, Mr. Gravelli.
Well done, my boy. This is gonna be a fruitful partnership for us both.
You'll never make it on stage.
You just can't help getting sucked in on the way down.
Don't make me kill you.
Five contestants, one fading dream, a ton of alcohol and turn abuse. Right. The Stars is the ultimate reality show. Like in reality, everyone likes you. Then you turn into a depressed drug and mess. Turn. Enjoy watching one smug celebrities who have hit rock bottom. Stay there. Waiting with the Stars, a new season coming soon on Weasel.
You have arrived.
Problem with these guys, I can't even think straight.
So he's always there. He is. Welcome to the war, Counselor, my boy.
Gentlemen. What's going on?
Nothing. Discussing pest control.
Well, I've given you my advice, Peg.
you do what you think is best.
I agree.
Finally!
I mean, I don't agree with what he says. I agree that you know best.
Excuse me?
Relax. I didn't mean nothing by it. Look, either we make the right call or we all end up in prison anyway. Well, your crap ain't gonna do me no favors.
Be careful. See you later. Boss? Gentlemen?
You're only an associate, Phil. Remember that.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, tough
Boss,
guy.
I gotta tell you this. He's not straight. Right before I came in here, I saw him talking to Angie again.
You better leave. I need to speak to Nico.
Sure, boss. But, think about what I said.
I will.
You know?
Trust me on that. We got real problems. Police are all over us. Maybe you heard, I got served papers today. Phil, yesterday. We got a couple of boys in jail. I think they might squeal. Somebody's talking. Wants us out of the picture. Maybe John Gravelli. Or them Ancelotti's. Somebody got to my people.
So what are you going to do about it?
I don't know. I gotta shut someone up and show people I mean business. I've known Phil a long time. He's straight, more or less. I know him and Angie are friends, but that don't worry me too much. Maybe he's too straight. Then there's Ray. I don't know. I don't trust him. But he's a good earner. I know he's got his eye on the big prize, but he's no dummy. Him and Phil hate each other. I gotta think about it.
Okay.
I'll give you a call. Whoever I say to go see him. And shut him up!
That's your decision, Mr. Pecorino. It's done.
Calculating route.
It's long. 598.8.
pea-stained mattress and cry. Tie off my arm.
The cause of corporate America. That's freedom. Independence FM.
Weasel News Time. Probably gonna tell us about.
I see his car.
He should be heading over to a chop shop in Fuego. Don't get too comfortable with him, Nico. Like every rat, he's a survivor. He's got good instincts. He has a bad feeling about you in particular. He bought some protection and he ain't gonna hang around and wait for you know what to happen. Then again, I'll get a chump muscle to stop for gas on the way. It might create a good opportunity for you.
Speak for themselves, as nothing is more important in sports than winning at all costs. He also said his job is quite difficult because teen girls are fucking hot. Numerous gymnasts have accused her of...
It's a fucking head!
Went to plan, Mr. Pegorino.
Clean it out, it's a tough job, Belichick. I don't got much left in mind, it's so clean. I'll talk to you soon.
Concludes that the vast majority of light beer drinkers are bi-curious metrosexuals who run at the faintest taste. Tantamount to castrating yourself, said Pride Brew's director of PR, especially if you put a piece of lime in it. Dude and like may be endangered words. At a conference held in Stockholm last week to discuss age-appropriate use of American English, linguists were divided over the word dude. Some believe that it should be phased out by the late 20s.
Forgive me, my friend.
Christ, so bloody mighty.
Men only up to the age of 25, but women could carry it off if they kept their figure up to the age of 37. For now, the debate on the age in which you should stop saying dude, like, homie, or bitching rages on.
You have a
this is Weasel News, homie.
This is Weasel News. Radio for people just like you. Loners who used to send girls mixtapes. Independence FM.
Is always wrong.
Shut the fuck up!
But you can make it right.
You got a problem!
Like a genetically modified plant, grown hydroponically in chemicals by peasants in Honduras. You may have done wrong. It's time to make it right.
Thank you, Bryce Dawkins. I hope the cash for this didn't come out of city funds. Okay.
It is okay. Fucking dick.
Calm down. I'll see you later.
Fuck you!
What's wrong?
I can't do it anymore. I can't do it! I've really fucked up this time. I screwed over a job. I'm gonna get killed. And I'm not really like this.
No? What kind of heroin-addicted prostitute are you like?
I've got a nice family. I'm just fucked up. I've gotta go home. Can you take me to the station? I've got a mom and a dad, and they're not so bad. I've gotta go home.
Where's home?
The Midwest. It's pretty boring, but this is no life. Look at me. I was a fucking cheerleader once.
What are you talking about? It's fantastic.
Hey. Come on. Let's go.
I gotta get to Grand Eastern Terminal.
Yards. Turn right.
This is a good move. How long have you been living on the streets?
Ever since I got to this city. On my way here, I actually thought it was going to be difficult. I thought that in Liberty City, everybody was a somebody. Maybe some big producer was going to discover me on the street.
Didn't go like that, did it?
Well, some producer discovered me, but I didn't exactly end up in a Vinewood movie. I ended up with a two-bag-a-day habit. Videos of me doing shit I hadn't even heard of on the internet.
Motherfucker.
They pick us up when we get off the bus. Girls and guys. Wish I'd known that before I got here.
I wish you had too. Have some cash, Marnie. Look after yourself.
I'll try, Nico. Thanks. I was right. You are sweet.
In 100 yards.
The room from the club.
Did you just call me?
No, man. Must have been someone else.
Yeah, must have been. I was in the shower and I heard the phone ringing, so I thought you might have called or something. My bad. Later.
What? Careful!
Hey, it's Nico. You hungry? Want to grab some food?
Sure, I'll hang with you. Pick me up in the next hour.
Okay, man. I'm heading over. Well, I see my invisibility pills are still working.
With restaurants you never heard of. If you go to Star Junction, you see people getting their
to Exeter Avenue.
Okay, then. Here we go.
Don't fuck about. Let's go.
If you say so.
At this very moment, and later. Piece of rice. Then I'm gonna take Georgie, huh, to the Statue of Happiness, right, Georgie?
Yes.
Yes, so we're gonna remind him that some people actually play by the rules and immigrate legally. But me and Georgie, we don't play by the rules, do we?
No.
We are the outlaws of radio, right?
Yes.
Outlaws. And you're driving, and I'm hanging out the passenger side window, blam, 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 you know, shooting at the cops, and I hit one of the tires, and it flips over, and they all crawl out. And none of them are hurt, just like on TV. We are outlaws of radio because I can make you laugh and Georgie can do some drywall work.
Fuck you, Laszlo.
Listen, me Jefe, I'm the boss. I'm here teaching you. I'm the professor of radio at the University of Laszlo. Georgie, tell me, how does my picture look, huh?
Here we are, man.
My great, thanks.
Air, my romantic disposition.
Hey, Nico, let's find a car.
Hello? What are you...
Let me tell you, man. I never wanted to be no drug dealer.
No?
No. I wanted to be... Shit, this will make you laugh. You know what I wanted to be?
No.
I wanted to be a cop.
Really? Why didn't you become one?
Now, this is 20 years ago. They didn't encourage black policemen back then.
I guess not.
Nah. I couldn't read so good anyway. But I could add up and I could scare people. So I started slinging dope. The money was insane. Crack took off and it went crazy. I had apartments full of money. Whole apartments stuffed with banknotes.
You're joking, right?
Nah. Never made me happy, though. Made me fucking miserable, paranoid, angry. I wasn't even smoking the shit, but I was good at it. The best. Sort of fun and sort of like living in hell. Seeing your old schoolmates turn into zombies and knowing they was gonna be your best customers. Man, what a fucking life.
Internet on your phone. What a great invention. Updating your social networking.
This kind of a fancy place. Think I'm gonna like this. Hey, man, good chilling with you. We should do this again. Hit me up soon, son.
I think you should be allowed to buy a license to smoke inside.
Agreed.
Friend.
Why? What's wrong?
I think it's my conscience. I don't know.
Your conscience? Have you killed too many people, Nico?
Perhaps. That man who I worked for, Ray Bocino, I was asked to kill him and I did. He was a cockroach. Pest. But I don't know how long I can keep on dealing in death.
It must be difficult. Maybe there is another path to take. A less violent one. I'll speak to you soon, okay?
I'm pushing it to the max, rolling deep, baby. Leave me a message.
Please leave a message.
got this number because nobody's calling. If you gotta hold it, leave me a message.
Hi, Carmen. Is Carmen there? I'd like to take you out on a date.
I was sure you was either dead or in prison. Ben don't wait this long before calling Carmen again. My other arrangements got canceled. I'll go on a date with you. Come get me in the next hour.
I'll come get you, Carmen.
Hey, Nico, you taking Carmen somewhere good? Oh, I like the new car. It can't have been cheap. Nico, you shouldn't wear that top no more. Those are some nice pants. They must have been expensive. I'm digging the new shoes, Nico!
You'd even force me to die a bag of candy cane!
You have arrived.
Even celebrities eat fast food. It's food for everyone, no matter who you are. Maybe you can give Carmen the money you would have spent at a real restaurant.
So, what are you into, Carmen? What do you really like?
I don't know, honey. I like boys. I like looking good. I like watching TV.
Yeah? What do you watch?
All type of stuff. How else are you gonna learn about the world?
If your picture of the world comes from the TV you watch in this country, then you've got to have a pretty distorted view.
For sure. If you watch those big Vinewood movies and sitcoms and stuff,
I'm not so sure.
They got a reality TV show for everything now. Rich people, cars, hookers. They should make a show about me. I look better than most of them bitches on there anyways.
Sure. Well, what would happen in your show?
I just live, you know? It'd tell everyone out there what it's like for a girl coming out of South Bohan, trying to make something of herself.
Sounds like compelling view. You want me to come inside with you?
Carmen wants you in here.
All right.
You cannot hold Carmen down. You can't. Carmen likes this. Oh.
The kind of healthcare professional she is.
Yourself, all right?